Welcome to Sly Gittin's Tech Simplified channel. And in today's video, I want you to ask yourself, have you ever been in this situation when you're opening up an email, you start reading through it, you get to a link, and you're about to hover over the mouse, and you're not sure should you click on it or not? I know I've been there plenty of times. What if I told you Microsoft 365 had a solution to ensure that your organization data would be safe even if you clicked on that link? And that tool is the Microsoft Office ATP SafeLink solution. And we're gonna get into how does it help your organization and help you to feel comfortable clicking on any link in your environment.
Knowledge is king. Knowledge is king. Knowledge is king. Knowledge is...
It's important to know, what do you need to get started? So the first thing you wanna know is make sure you have the right license, all right? Do your license include Office 365 ATP Threat Protection, P1 or P2? If it does, you're good to go. If you're not, that's the first place you wanna start. Next, make sure you have the proper roles enabled for the people who need to deploy these policies. So a global administrator is great, a security administrator, an Exchange Online organization management role is also great. And the next thing you want to make sure you have is make sure that the Office clients are configured to use modern authentication. And this is helpful when you're trying to protect those Microsoft Office documents. And then lastly, you know, make sure you learn about how do you leverage the different policies, especially if you're going to do custom policies. I'm going to focus on the default policies on this video, but one thing I will do is include this documentation in the description below. The first place I need you to go to is admin.microsoft.com. And once you get there, go to security. And once this page loads, I need you to go to threat management, click on dashboard. And then once you get the dashboard, click on configure ATP safe links. And then once that happens, we're going to go and create a new policy by clicking this plus sign that stands for new. And then we're going to name it test. And then we're going to go through and start adding the information that applies to our organization. So we do want to turn this feature on and use Teams. I want to make sure I check those links in there. I want to deliver that email instantaneously and also do the URL scanning from there. And then we also want to do safe links for email messages. So we have to do that. And now we got to make sure, who do we want to apply this to? I want to apply this to the entire domain that I'm leveraging, but I also want to make one exception. I want to protect my account, so just in case it doesn't work out, I can go back and change that actual policy to ensure that it's working correctly. So now I'm going to click save, and now you see that we completely set up and created an Office 365 ATP safe link. And it didn't take that much time.
So you just finished watching the Microsoft 365 ATP safe link in action. And I created that policy to help protect your organization from those malicious links. So what's next? Keep watching the videos in my channel. I curate Microsoft security videos, IT certification videos to help you further your career. So the next thing I need you to do to show me that you love these videos is continue your membership if you already subscribed, but if you haven't, click that button to subscribe and also click the button to stay notified. Well, until next time, Sly Gittin's is out.